I didn't speak in perfect Italian, but it's still something you can write.
Oh, well done. Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the 2013 Edinburgh Fringe documentary for Slap and Giggle. Sid here, James here, and we're back doing our new show. Tell them about it, James.
It's called Slap and Giggle Recharged.
And it's a sketch show. It's a sketch show, ladies and gentlemen. On at 5:15 at venue 96, which is opening down on Cowgate, 14th to the 24th of August 2013, part of PBH's Free Fringe, which is a fantastic institution.
Oh, yes.
We're back here this year doing yet another documentary due to popular demand.
And we've got some new tricks.
We're experimenting with talking heads this year in the documentary.
It's a gimmick. We have no original ideas.
So not only have we got our new tricks, but we've also been working on some new material this year. I'm very confident about my new stuff.
I'm Sid.
Yay!
I'm Sid!
Yay!
I'm Sid!
Yay!
I am Sid! Hello!
And I've got some new material too.
James! 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 James!
Well, I'm sure it's going to turn out really well, James.
I've got a very strong feeling about it.
A strong feeling or a good feeling? Well, I guess we'll find out, won't we? So, ladies and gentlemen, sit back and enjoy our 2013 Slap and Giggle Edinburgh Fringe experience.
That'd be really good.
Yeah,
so we're in a service station, obviously. And,
oh, that's the first one there.
What's that?
Buy ice by book.
And it'll just be a bit, go to a service station.
Fantastic.
That's 25 points right there.
Fantastic. Well, we're doing quite the Edinburgh experience, so we're nearly there. Edinburgh Festival 2013.
Yeah, I guess again we're on the borderline of Scotland.
Yep, very exciting times. I've got to say, it's going to be a great year this year.
Yeah.
Edinburgh's always, you know, the highlight of my year.
What about your wedding?
Right, obviously the wedding was the highlight of my year, and Edinburgh's just second place.
Well, what about the stag do that I organised?
Well, that's just the...
Okay, I'm sorry. The stag do was the best thing, then the wedding, then Edinburgh.
What about the birth of your child?
Oh, yeah. No, stag do's better than that.
What about your surprise birthday party?
My birthday's next week.
Oh, right, yeah.
We best get going, mate.
You're
going
to
be late.
Oh, wait.
What?
Found another one.
Fantastic.
Okay, so for music, we have Michael Jackson. William Roach sings the hits. That's who that is.
Ken Barlow.
Ken Barlow, yeah. And
Rolf Harris.
Right, not really comfortable with those artists for moral reasons. What else have we got?
Only other thing I can find is Leonard Nimoy and William Shatner.
Well, I think the choice is clear there.
Yeah, I suppose.
Timey kangaroo down, sport. Timey kangaroo down. Timey kangaroo down, sport. Timey kangaroo down.
Take me koala back, Jack. Take me koala back. Somewhere out on the track,
Meg.
So take me,
come on, Meg, all again. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down, sport. Tie me kangaroo down.
Alright?
Yeah.
Okay.
And here we are.
Fantastic. We're staying in this hotel?
No. The car.
What?
We're staying in the car.
What?
Staying in the car. Staying in the car. What a joker. What a joker. Classic James. Nah. He dropped that whole joke after 3 or 4 minutes of me being quite distressed. And then he revealed that it was all a joke. And then he drove around for a while trying to find what he called the right place. And then he did. He parked up, came on in, had a look around and found our flat. And it's really nice, really nice. Sid is here.
I didn't have many choices. Just picked a flat, broke in, no one was home. Boom.
This is really nice, James. How'd you manage this?
Secret.
Well done, mate. Nice flat.
Yeah. Let me go in.
Yeah?
Yeah!
So, who else is staying here? Is anyone else staying here?
Maybe. No. Looks like they're on holiday.
I don't know how he's organised it. I don't know how much he's paid for it. It's a really nice place. Well done, James.
What if they come back? God, what if they come back? Sid? Sid, pack up your stuff!
Where are you, Terry? Is he over there?
No!
Well, is he over there?
No!
He's invisible, so how do you know?
Well, I'd be invisible, but I still see his shadow!
Oh, wait a minute. What's that over there? Is it a shadow? Could it be? Terry! You've come back to me! Come on, old friend, join in the song, just like the old days. One or two, your piano solo. Terry, that's not how you play the piano. Put your pants back on. Imaginary Terry.
Loads of gigs this year, loads of gigs. We're actually doing 27 gigs in 10 days, which is a huge amount. We're doing Sweet Release, Dead Famous, C Nova, we're doing something down at Dragonfly, we're doing stuff at Opium on Dead Cat Comedy Club as well. Loads of stuff this year, very exciting, lots of fun.
Okay, so we're at the first of our external gigs, and this is the Sweet Release. We do it every year. Let's see how we do.
Yeah!
We're on check.
Here by nearly 4%, visit Bristol.
So that's example.
That's just one. Right. Oh,
another one. Can we do this or
not? Right, we're about to do a gig at a place called Recovery Fringe. It's for recovering alcoholics and drug dealers. Drug addicts. So we'll fit in very well here. Very looking forward to it. And I think this is too.
We're doing an hour every couple of days for this. It's going to be very exciting. It's a guy who wants a gig.
What are you wearing?
What? The hat?
Yeah.
Do you like it? I got it earlier. I saw it and I thought, that's quite nice.
Yeah?
Yeah, you like it?
Yeah, I know. It's really nice, mate. Yeah?
Yeah. Thanks, mate. That's really nice of you to say.
Yeah, I think it brings out your eyes.
Do you like it? I thought it might, be good to promote the show.
Mm-hmm. It might get you a bit of female attention.
I'm really pleased James likes the hat so much. I mean, it's not cheap, but it's not about the cost, it's about how it looks. It was a gamble, and, well, I'm so pleased he can be so honest with me.
What the heck does he have on his head? That is not a hat that humans should be allowed to wear.
I just thought, you know, maybe if we wear a hat, it'll get us a bit of attention when we're...
You'll definitely get some attention.
Yeah? Yeah, I thought it might be good for flyering and stuff. And also when we're out on the streets, just trying to promote our show on the stage as well. Because I have very low confidence.
That'll help. It will help.
Thanks, mate.
Can you just excuse me?
Yeah,
sure. Should I go to the toilet?
Probably just thinking about our set coming up. No, it's a bit surprising because there aren't any jokes in it.
It's horrible. I hate it.
All staff controls his magic. The pool can no longer afford to pay his staff at £4.25. As a nationwide treasure, but there's no longer any treasure in his account at Nationwide.
Go on.
Go
on. Oh.
Winner. Pick a card from the deck. What do you get?
All right, so here we are. Yet again, we're going to climb Arthur's Seat. It's a bit of a tradition now, isn't it?
Yeah.
Bit of a disaster last year because we didn't actually climb
the right one.
Turns out there are two seats, apparently.
Stupid two seats.
Stupid two seats. Andy was our manager, and he's disappeared in mysterious circumstances about 3-4 weeks ago. He's presumed dead. It's very sad, but he's a very keen bowler. Andy, and I think while we're here, we should try and commemorate his memory. So he's asked, oh God, from beyond the grave, came to me in a dream, that he wants us to bring his favourite bowling ball up until the top of the mountain. I know it's hit James very hard.
I don't know who he's talking about.
Yeah. Okay, so you right to carry that, James?
What?
So there you are.
Okay. Oh God!
You're right. Wow, okay, so we're about halfway up the mountain now. That's the easy part over, so far so good. So what we're gonna do now, we're gonna get to the peak. You alright, James? Yeah? Do you wanna swap? No? Okay, let's go then, come on. Come on. Okay, that's the peak. We're nearly there, okay? Nearly at the top, James, come on! We're doing this for Andy, remember. Gotta admit, it's starting to feel... What? James, no! No! God, no, James!
Do you want to go down and get it?
Andy anyway. On reflection, I'm glad I fell over and dropped the ball down the mountain.
Okay, so after some discussion, we decided we're not going to bother climbing the rest of the mountain. It was all for Andy's memory.
Who?
But,
You know, there's that bloke who followed us around to all those gigs, and he was quite short and had that big bushy beard. No, that was my mum. No.
No one liked Andy. I didn't. Never got us any gigs. He's too busy bowling.
I hope I never see him again. God damn it, we were so close this time!
We had no choice, it was 9 a.m. We had to open the shop, but we almost had the cure!
Get your priorities right, Peter! This is Cancer Research UK! We are a charity shop first, and a research lab second!
The great thing about Edinburgh is you don't just get to see one thing, there's a bit of everything. You got comedy, music, us as well. There's dance and theatre and also magic.
We're here with Rich Hughes.
Hello.
Part of a comedy triple act called We Are Goose.
They're my faves, yes.
Whoa!
Oh my god! Where did you come from?
Are you Jesus?
I'm like Jesus, but better.
Wow! How are you better?
Better looking.
Alive.
Okay.
I am a wizard. Would you like to see some wizardry?
Yes! Wizard us!
I see your wand.
Later.
Yes!
What is your favourite bodily function, sir?
Well, I
coughing. I see. Good, thank you for that. And you, sir, you seem like a smoker.
Do I now?
You have cigarettes. Don't you? We have the matches.
Oh! Oh my god! Oh!
Exactly like Jesus!
Wait, was I wrong? Are you not a smoker?
No.
No, then you won't need these matches.
Oh! No! No!
I can only presume that he had a wire that was sort of going into, I don't know, some secret compartment in his jeans or something, which he had the matches on, and then he pressed the button with the mechanism in his, I don't know, belt, concealed area, and then it sort of like fired out the matches. It's the only explanation.
That magic really freaked me out. I mean, it was, and his hands were, and it was there. Oh.
How he made them disappear, I don't know.
Okay, here we are again at Recovery Fringe. This is a nice little gig that we've done a few times now. Basically what it is that it's an hour-long set that we do for recovering alcoholics.
We're a little bit early. Do you want to stay here and get some food, or...?
We have some time to kill.
Yeah, it is.
Yes! Yeah.
Gigs we've ever done. I was fab, she was fab, audience were shouting, they loving it, absolutely loving it. I think, we're definitely coming back here.
James has an addictive personality in that most people are addicted to not spending time with him because of his personality. I know I certainly am. But he picks up things very quickly. He gets very into sort of things like, well, drugs is a big problem.
I love drugs. But it's not a problem. I mean, I don't want to let it get in the way or the Edinburgh experience. But, you know, we are essentially stars. And I think stars do need to have drugs to have a good time. That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to have a good time with the help of narcotics.
Excuse me, mysterious stranger. Do you know where I can get some drugs?
No.
Do you know where we can buy any drugs?
Do you know where I
I can buy any drugs.
Please give me some drugs. Excuse me, Tigger. Do you know where I can get any drugs?
No.
Do you know where I can buy some drugs?
No. Do you have any drugs?
Do you know where I can buy some drugs?
I'm looking for some drugs.
Do you know I can buy any drugs?
No.
Can I buy some drugs from you?
I'm sorry.
Sorry, do you know where I can buy any drugs?
No, I'm dying. Sorry, no.
Excuse me, do you know where I can buy some drugs?
No.
Do you know where I can get any drugs?
No, you bad man, no!
I think I'm pretty good at judging people, and so that really does help when it comes to finding drugs. I met loads of really friendly people who all are trying to help me find the drugs. Few teething problems, though.
James loves drugs. He can't get enough of them. Literally, he can't get enough of them. And he's consequently ODing, that's overdosing, frequently. And it's starting to become a problem in that most of his time is spent by asking people where he can get drugs, and then most mornings is spent down A&E after he's OD'd on them. He's not always too good at getting good drugs, though.
Come on, James. Wakey, wakey. Time to get up. Oh, God. James! You've OD'd! Oh, God, James! What on this time?
Vitamin tablets.
I feel so healthy.
Those were my vitamin tablets. He had no right.
Vitamin tablets didn't make me feel healthy. I was sick afterwards.
Come on, James. Another day, another dollar. Wakey, wakey. Oh, God, not again. James, James, what is it this time? James.
Vocal zone?
James, you only supposed to have one of these every 2 hours.
You do sound better.
Oh, thank you.
I mean, yeah, his voice has improved. But that doesn't change the fact that he's still OD'd on vocal zone. I mean, they're dangerous pastels.
I thought they were special E tablets. But they weren't E tablets. They were vocal zone.
Come on then, James. Big day today. We need to get up. We need to get down to the... Oh, God. God, it's a bad one. It's a bad one. James. James. What is it? Dove.
Yeah. My hands feel really smooth.
Dove.
Dove? How can you OD on Dove?
Oh, God. See, isn't Dove great? It feels like a baby just touching my face. But a baby with massive man hands. Oh.
You may have noticed some prices appearing at certain points throughout the documentary. Basically, what's happening here is that last year's 2012 Edinburgh documentary, it's got 400 hits on YouTube, nearly. And basically, I thought maybe we can try and capitalise on that. So I've entered into some negotiations from certain companies. They haven't signed it off yet. But hopefully, it will mean that every time someone watches our video, because of the product placement, we get 8p. When I say we, I get 8p.
Right, James, we're going to have to do a really big push today because we got all the... Oh, for Christ's sake! Lips has gone blue. Foaming at the... What is it this time? McLean's? Oh, for Christ's sake!
What? It was just toothpaste. I didn't OD, I just brushed my teeth and then fell asleep on the couch.
Flyering's always difficult, And the thing is, it's finding the right sort of pitch with the customer. You know, you're trying to sell your show, and there's so many other people selling their shows, and so it's a difficult game to play. But I think we've hit our stride.
Hit him. Go on, hit him.
Do you want to hit
him? Can you hit him? Yeah, can you just hit him in the face? How is this working? Why are they taking them? You're offering nothing.
I know. Some people are just, that's it.
You're just saying what it is. That's the advertising point.
This is a flyer.
Exceptional.
Award-winning sketch comedy. Sorry, I know it's a very funny hat, but can you not make jokes at my friend's expense? Because he'll think it is actually a good hat.
It's a fucking awesome hat.
Do you know where I can buy any drugs?
Award-winning sketch comedy this afternoon. Free award-winning sketch comedy. Come and get it, ladies and gentlemen. Free award-winning sketch comedy.
Oh,
might be
wow, running. That's a really nice hat.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You like it, yeah?
Yeah, it's really nice.
Thank you. A lot of people don't like this hat. Do you think I look good in it?
I think you look dashing.
PM. Come on, get them while they're hot. 5:15 today, free award-winning sketch comedy. They're right here. Come on.
Oh my
come
God.
On.
Can I just say that hat looks amazing?
Really?
Yeah, I saw you over there and I was like, oh my God. But now I'm up close, not just the hat, just the whole thing.
Thank you very much. That's such a nice thing
to
say.
I bet you've been to that
tour
day then.
Actually, yeah, they have.
Have they?
Ever since I put the hat on.
So it's not special that I'm still on.
No, it is special. Do you mean it? I'm not joking.
No, I was hoping that maybe, because I was nice about the hat, and maybe, you know.
You and...
Oh, no. You know.
No, it's fine. Yeah. Okay, yeah.
Thank you.
Girls love the hat.
Girls love the hat?
There's so many different flyering techniques, of course. There's the ghost. There's yes, yes, yes.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes.
Surprise! It doesn't really matter what you do in terms of flyering, as long as it gets people through the door.
Okay, so here we are, welcome again, same venue as last year. It's a great venue, and with great staff as last year. Here we have Brett, our good friend Brett. How are you doing, Brett?
I'm good, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good, thanks, very good, yeah.
In
the ladies, guilty as charged.
Hey James, who's that?
This is Jess from last year.
Lovely.
We almost had a little thing, but something got in the way.
Yes.
Hitting me in the face.
Exactly. That's just one of the many things that got in the way.
Yeah.
Big blues.
Big blues. Big blues.
What's that you're drinking there, Jess?
Starbucks.
You just hold it up. Hey, that looks really nice.
Yeah. Beautiful.
Starbucks.
What?
Socialising in Edinburgh is the best. You get to meet so many people, and everyone's so friendly, especially to us. I bet he's taken something.
I was taking something.
The piss!
And acid.
We basically make money from the shows by, at the end, we hold up a bag, or some other shows do bucket, and people put money in as they go. Okay, so it's free to get in, not so free to get out. That's just one of the jokes that we use as people are leaving.
Okay, so yeah, here we are. I'm just about to start our show. The doors are open, most of the audience are in there. It's going to be a good one. There's lots of people in social. Rob Brimstone! Rob
Bennison from last year, amazing, how's it going?
We stayed with Rob last year, it was
we'll show them beta matches, it was good.
Yeah, no, it was really, really nice.
Have you, I think last year, the 20 quid you owe me from last year.
Oh, yeah, sorry. There you are.
Jim.
Thanks, Aram. Thanks for coming to see our show, Rob.
It wasn't a pleasure to see Rob Frimston from Frimston and Rowett again. No, we stayed with Rob last year, and he took us for a lot of money. Wasn't nice to see him again.
Okay, so the end of another show. Went really well. Thanks so much, guys. Thanks for coming. Thank you. Cheers. Thank you very much. Thank you. Great show. Very good. The nice thing about the shows is that even though they are free, people put a lot of money in here. And that's how we survive. It's making that little bit of cash. And usually it's just enough for a meal. You know, people put a couple of quid in. So it's a really nice thing to do.
Now, I don't want to name names, but someone stole our money.
I don't know where the money could have gone. How? Who would take that money?
It was Rob Frimston. He did the same thing last year, he's doing the same thing again. God, I hate Rob Frimston. Frimston! Damn you, Rob Frimston!
Okay, here we are with one of our good friends, James Quisson, who's a fantastic comedian. He's doing something today. What's your show called?
Sorry.
Thank you.
It really
takes
something out.
Doesn't it just? Yeah, I'm getting that a lot recently. Thank you very much.
Hey, James. Do you know where I can buy any drugs?
Yeah, absolutely.
Should we go now?
Come on, then.
We'll be very happy together. Anything.
Well, if the hat fits...
Ooh, I love your hat. Fantastic colours,
Matt. Thank you very much.
What's your name, young sir?
Oh, see.
What are you doing, mate?
Well, looking for a hat stand, I expect.
Okay, so we've come back to Apex Hotel. We did a gig here last night. We've just come back now to pick up our stuff because we've been home in between.
Sid, I'm so glad I've seen you again. You left your hat in my hotel room last night.
Oh, thanks for bringing it back.
It's not a problem.
The hat works.
Okay, here we are at Sweet Release, and we're with our favourite techie, Sharpie. He's a fantastic guy, a man's man. Aren't you, Sharpie? Now, you do the tech.
Hey.
It's very good.
Hey. I really like your hat.
Really?
Yeah, that's really
Thank
nice.
You. You're not the first person to
say Oh, for God's sake! I'm wearing a hat now!
Hmm. I really like your hat, James.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Oh.
Well, one thing's for sure. The hat works. By God, the hat works. The hat really, really, really works. Oh God. Oh God.
Another day, another dollar with another win.
Brett.
Good old Brett.
Very
our best friend, Brett.
How are we doing?
Very well, thank you, Brett. Yeah, this is
good. Thank you, again.
Again?
But, if the guy fails, it's like...
The gents.
Oh, yeah, sorry, Ian. Guilty as charged.
Excuse me, I really like your hat.
Oh, thank you. Finally!
Well, here we have Harry. Harry's one of our very good friends. We see him every year at the Fringe. He's often flying, he's often come to our shows as well. And the nice thing about Harry is that he never lies. Isn't that right, Harry?
I don't know, is it?
Oh, but there you are, honestly.
Yeah.
Are you going to come and see our show?
Yes, of course. That is not a lie. There we go. That's the truth.
Yeah. You just have to look into his eyes to see he's telling the truth.
The sun's in the way.
Yes, I have.
James loves his iSpy book. I mean, he's just going around ticking things off all the time. It's so good that he has a hobby and something to sort of occupy him throughout Edinburgh.
Hey, hey, Sid, Sid, look, the castle.
Oh yeah, so it is the castle as well. Yeah, tick it off.
I've seen the castle.
I love my iSpy book. It means I've actually got to see more of Edinburgh than I've ever seen before. There's so many stuff that you walk along, you don't notice. And I think, with a mind like mine, you need to see as many things as you can. Yes. It's educational, it's spiritual, it's archaeological, it's... other words ending in coal. I've learned so much already.
Do you want to put him on your book?
I spy with my little eye something beginning with E. No, it's Edinburgh.
Okay. So, when are you taking off?
Well, I've seen all the three shows here, look.
All in one dive.
Yeah.
Great. Great. This is full. Fantastic.
Hey, loads of points.
Awesome. Have you done out the sea? Have you been on the Royal Mile?
Yeah. Yes, I have.
Took it off. Have you had some haggis?
Yes, I did.
Took it off. Did you sleep with a man?
No.
Now we're in the bedroom. No more.
It's going so well.
Can I do that again?
No.
Which one? Thank you very much. See you later, guys.
You smell amazing.
Thanks, James. Well, that'll be because of this Adidas deodorant that I'm wearing today.
Wow. Can I have some?
Of course you can. Okay, so just finished our penultimate show, one more to go, and we're not going to celebrate with the drugs, James. We're going to celebrate
James,
with a nice drink.
See, I've been looking for you guys everywhere.
Andy!
Guys, I came back to see your show.
Andy, where the hell have you been?
Oh, no, I did change my number about 3 weeks ago.
You changed your number? I assume that...
Well, I've been leaving you messages.
Oh, that's who that was.
Oh, so you're not going to introduce me to your friend?
It's our manager, Andy.
Who?
Oh, guys, by the way, have you got my bowling balls? This is a fantastic bowling
ball. Oh, habit. Bowling, Andy!
No, of course.
What?
Oh.
That is a really fetching hat, James.
Oh, for God's sake! I am sick of this! This sort of thing happens every year when we do a documentary. Well, no more! I never want to see you again. I never want to work with you again. No idea who he is. I'm leaving! God's sake! And I'm sick of this stupid hat!
Well, I wasn't really fussed about the hat, so I was quite surprised by James's response. Obviously, a lot of stuff's been getting to him, particularly men.
I'm so alone.
You look at a guinea pig.
Why, Bennison, why?
Where can I buy some drugs?
I don't know.
I heard like I'm
Because you have got one more show left.
And you have got one more show manager, Andy, right?
And I want my 15%.
Yeah, okay. So, the problem is, it could be anywhere. I mean, Edinburgh's a big place. Oh, it's there. Jake!
Well, Andy finally brought us back together. That's the first thing he's ever done for us, really. So, cheers, Andy.
One show to go, and Andy sorted it out. What a guy. Well done, Andy. Well done.
What's 15% of reconciliation?
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, we are Slap and Giggle!
Well, last show done. Let's go home, guys. Yeah!
It's a long drive home, so I'm taking speed.
What have I learned? Friendship lasts forever. Hard work always pays off. Never take shortcuts. And if you follow your dreams, one day they'll come true.
What have I learned? Nothing. Well, I think when I get back to Manchester, I'm going to stop doing drugs. Then I'm going to move to London, where they're much more readily available.
Will we do it again? Well, no.
So, the hunter comes, the hunted.